Hello and welcome back to the World Championship in Through the Ages. In the last game that you saw, I was able to win a very important and also very close two-player game against Watsonians, putting me now at 15 points in standings, 1 point behind LCFX and 9 points before Watsonians. And the game that we are seeing today could be really important for the outcome of this group, because it will be a three-player game against LCFWX and Watsonians, so the two opponents that have the best positions in the standings at the moment. It could be especially important for me if I finish before or behind LCFWX, but also for Watsonians. It will be a very important game if he wants to keep his chances alive. He really needs to win this one, but if he does, then he is definitely back in the running and keeps his chances alive. So that will be a very important game. And now, without further ado, we are going to take a look at the game. I'm playing in the first position in this game, and first of all, we can take a look at the leaders and wonders. And there's definitely some cultures in the Gene Age 3 with Marlene Dietrich, Fleming, Chaplin, and the Hollywood being there. There's also some labs in the G, especially with Bill Gates and Sid Meier. There's the Space Flight, the Manhattan Project, and then there is also Pierre and Mandela, and also the Red Cross. In Age 2, we have James Cook and the Suez Canal, so there's definitely some colony synergy. We have Maria Theresa and the Ocean Liner Service. We have the Railroad and the Harvard College, really some strong economical Age 2 wonders. Then we also have some culture leaders in Age 2 with Anthony Gaudí and Darwin, but no Bach and Shakespeare. And we have all of the three military action leaders with Catherine, Robespierre and Napoleon. Then we also have both of the military action leaders in Age 1 with Jan Žižka and Joan of Arc, Nostradamus, Genghis Khan can also help with the strength. We have Leonardo and Saladin as some economical leaders, and also Gutenberg, of course. Then we have Universitas and Silk Road as the two science wonders, and Machu Picchu as an economical wonder, as well as St. Peter's Basilica and the Taj Mahal. I'm in the first position, and at the end I made a decision to go for the engineering genius. I think the other options are just not that much appealing. If I go for Cleopatra, she of course can be a fine leader, but I don't know at all what wonder I will be getting with her. Maybe I will at the end get the Hanging Gardens, maybe I can go for Hanging Gardens in Richland, make sure that I can get my economy going while also using Cleo's resources. But that would be a bit costly, and I wouldn't like that combination too much. And if I go for the Colosseum, I don't like that wonder too much, and then I might be at the end with Colosseum plus maybe Caesar or Moses. And so I just went for the engineering genius. Now it definitely could be that at the next turn I have to go for Caesar and Moses, but at least I leave my wonder slot open. There are some interesting wonders that could come out of the deck with the library and the pyramids. There's also Universitas and Silk Road that could potentially be revealed early. So I think it should be best to just go for the engineering genius here. Watsonians will go for Colosseum and Cleopatra. I think that makes sense for him, because the next turn he can start with building the lab, and it should be very likely that a copy of Richland will be available for him, meaning that at the following turn he can then build one stage of the Colosseum without having to delay his third mine. And LCFWX, interestingly, goes for Hanging Gardens in the stockpile, but no, not that many options available for him. He might have the chance to get Moses at the next turn if I don't go for him, or he can maybe go for one of the leaders that will be revealed. For example, Hammurabi or Boudicca could be interesting, Aristotle as well, so I think that definitely makes some sense. And there are also some of those leaders revealed. At my turn I will build a mine, and then there are two leaders available for me for one civil action. I could go for Caesar, I could go for Moses. Both of my opponents have already committed to a wonder, so I will be guaranteed to get the pyramids at the next turn, and together with having the engineering genius, that is definitely quite nice. But it also made it that I didn't really want to go for Caesar. Of course, Caesar can be nice in first position, but I will go for the pyramids, meaning I have a wonder that gives me some economical benefits, and then I don't want to get distracted by the event deck being flipped very quickly, while both of my opponents have a wonder that maybe helps them a bit with the military, with the happy faces, and for what's needs also the additional military action. If the game gets a bit military heavy quickly, then those are definitely better prepared for that, and with that I didn't really want to go for Caesar, so I could just go for Moses now, elect him, and then increase my population. I get a little bit of economical value out of Moses, make sure that I have some population available. The next turn I can go for the pyramids, so that could maybe be quite fine. However, there are definitely also some other options, because if I, for example, take this urban growth, then at the next turn I could build my second lab with the urban growth, and thanks to also having the engineering genius, I would actually be guaranteed to be able to finish the pyramids in 2 turns while not having to delay my second lab, which could definitely be not that bad when playing in first position. On the next turn, the first H1 cards are only on two civil actions, and sometimes not even that many of them, meaning that if there aren't any interesting H1 cards available, it can sometimes be a bit difficult to spend the civil actions efficiently. So in first position, I think it definitely can be considered more to sometimes take an HA yellow card, because it might be that at the following turn there aren't that much better options to spend the civil actions on anyway, and in this case the urban growth doesn't only give me one resource, but if there are no developments revealed that would help me to finish the pyramids could even result in getting a civil action one turn earlier. So I then thought about maybe just taking the urban growth and then taking and electing Moses. However, if I already grabbed the urban growth and spend one civil action, maybe it could be fine to actually go for none of those leaders, grab another yellow card, which is of course not ideal because both the Patriotism and the Richland are not ideal with me already having built a third mine, but then I don't have to go for Moses, but instead can maybe go for Aristotle. Elsie will probably go for Hammurabi at his turn, then Aristotle would be left for me, and Aristotle is definitely a leader that I like more than having Moses. I really like it to have a bit of additional science available. Aristotle would be a nice combination with the pyramids. Maybe not ideal because I have already spent then two civil actions or even three with the engineering genius on just getting some yellow cards, so even when getting the additional civil action from the pyramids I might still be a little bit behind on with my civil actions, but at the end I actually made a decision to take the urban growth, take the rich land and increase my population, and then with the plan to go for Aristotle at the next turn. How good this will turn out will mostly depend on if there are some interesting cards for me in the row already the next turn. If yes, then I can't really take them and I'm definitely a bit inflexible. But if not, then maybe it's not too bad. If I at the end find a use case for the rich land, then I have now basically gotten two resources for two civil actions. That's similar to if I, for example, would have taken a rich land one for two civil actions at the next turn if one of those is in the row. So that's not too bad. And as said, the urban growth has the immediately... also the economic, the additional benefit of allowing me to finish the pyramids in two turns while also getting the second lab going. But it's of course still not ideal to spend that many civil actions and HA yellow cards, you have to be very careful with that, but if you are doing something like this, then I think it mostly can be justified in first position, where on the third turn there are sometimes not that great options available anyway. Watson Yates will go for electing Leo, building a lab, and then as expected will go for the rich land, allowing him to build a step and the mine at the next turn. Elsie will build his third mine, goes for Hammurabi and increases his population, and there are indeed some interesting cards coming down the road. There's a copy of Code of Laws and a copy of Knights. Both of those cards definitely would be nice to have, especially maybe with Aristotle. However, I have already the pyramids. With having that, the Code of Laws is always a little bit of a luxury, and as you can see, I've drawn a Legion tactic, so maybe it's not too bad at the end that I now won't be able to take any of those cards, because I think that would just be too expensive to take them, with me wanting to go for Aristotle and the pyramids. So at my turn I will go for the pyramids, I will go for Aristotle, I want to build my second lab, I can, thanks to having built it with the urban growth, still finish the pyramids at the following turn. And then the question was basically, could of course increase my population, but I don't want to get into consumption that early, and maybe it's also not that likely that a lot of events will be pushed with Elsie having Hammurabi. And with that, the main question was for me, do I want to build one step already with the engineering genius and the pyramids, or do I want to elect Aristotle? Building the step could have the advantage that if, for example, something like Silk Road is in the row, at the next turn I can finish the pyramids, take the Silk Road. However, that wouldn't be an ideal synergy with Aristotle, because the Silk Road would again take a lot of civil actions to build, and then also grabbing some technologies could be quite difficult. So at the end I just went for electing Aristotle. That could have the advantage that if, for example, there's a copy of Iron available for two civil actions at the next turn, I could just take it with Aristotle and go for one upgrade before finishing the pyramids, and with that I at the end choose to go for electing Aristotle. But if I finish the pyramids at the next turn, and then it maybe doesn't make a big difference at the end. I was a little bit worried that my opponents might be getting some nice stuff at their next turns, because Watson Yates at his turn I thought very likely wants to build a mine and a step, and then there's a Code of Laws available and maybe something like Knights, meaning that he probably won't take the monarchy, and then the monarchy falls down for one civil action for LCA, and he could even just take the monarchy and do revolution immediately. That could be very strong for him. But there's another copy of Code of Laws coming down the road, so if Elsie would do this at the end, maybe I can get a second copy of Code of Laws with Aristotle, and that maybe could also be somewhat fine for me. Then I draw two colonization cards. There is a Suez Canal in the game, so maybe I could can try to keep those cards in hand. Watson gets seats and opens the development of settlement. He will take the code of laws, the knights, builds a step, and the third mine, so that basically went as expected. However, the next turn will go a little bit different than what I expected, because Elsie actually goes for the code of laws, builds the second lab, and then plays the stockpile, increases population, so he just ignores the monarchy, interestingly. Interesting decision. I think an early revolution with Hammurabi is still quite strong. Maybe he was worried that if he goes for a revolution, for example, instantly, then the second copy of Code of Laws will be taken away, meaning he might be stuck on five civil actions for quite a while, with both of the Code of Laws being gone. But I think that could maybe still be somewhat fine, but he rather wants to have the Code of Laws, maybe wants to wait for an H2 government form, and actually leaves me the monarchy, which I was happy about, because I, with having the pyramids, like the monarchy quite a bit. It can serve as a long-term government solution, and with Aristotle might allow me to take even more technologies. Once I have finished the pyramids and developed the monarchy, I will beat six civil actions. And for Elsie, maybe taking both monarchy and code of laws and preparing for a revolution wasn't that easily possible, so maybe at the end he just said, let's don't go for the monarchy, or maybe just doesn't like it too much to be on the H1 government form, and then maybe not having a way to get a sixth civil action, which definitely can be problematic. This turn I don't want to see it, because I have a relatively nice turn that I can do, and if there are some additional resources or food revealed, then I would have some corruption issues, because this turn I just want to finish the pyramids. We can see there is actually the Silk Road, so if I would have built a step, I could have now had the option at least to take the Silk Road, but I think it wouldn't be the best thing to do anyway. I think it's a lot better for me now to just finish the pyramids, take the monarchy and the swordsman. I have the Legion tactic in hand, both of those cards will score me one science when I take them, and in the next turn I have now even enough science to go for the monarchy if I like to. Maybe there's also the chance that I can go for a copy of Iron or Alchemy, so there hopefully will be some nice options for me available, and with having the swordsman I also have a way now to get a little bit of additional strength going. Then I will already reveal the Legion tactic in order to keep two defense cards in hand, and I will also draw the medieval army tactic, making it that maybe taking knights later on could also be an option. Watson Yates this turn will finish the Colosseum using Cleo's resource again, and then will switch immediately to Saladin. I think Cleo worked out very nicely for him here. He managed to get her additional resource every turn, and now just when he ran out of projects, he can replace her with Saladin for one civil action, and I think that's definitely quite a strong start for him. And then he also gets the breakthrough, meaning that he can maybe develop the Code of Laws at the next turn, with still having a reasonable amount of science left to do some other important stuff. Elsie will take the iron for two civil actions, is missing one science to go for the immediately, will also go for the alchemy, the breakthrough, and then builds one step of the Hanging Gardens, so the next turn can maybe start going for some economical upgrades. Now it is my turn, I can't push, and during my turn, maybe the main decision is, I definitely will take the alchemy, scoring one science with Aristotle, but the question is, do I want to go for the alchemy already this turn, or do I rather want to go for the monarchy and then getting out of corruption with increasing my population, having more civil actions? But the problem is, if I go for the monarchy, I have, after increasing my population, still three civil actions left, and I just felt like this turn there isn't the greatest time to use that many civil actions. Because I could maybe take something like reserves, the warfare drama, or of course would score me a science with Aristotle, but all of those technologies I maybe don't really need that much, and then taking a rich land for two is somewhat fine, but also not that great, so I think maybe it is better to invest the civil actions into the alchemy upgrade this turn, and then have maybe more free civil actions at one of the following turns. So instead of developing the monarchy, I will just develop the alchemy immediately, go for one upgrade, I will increase my population, and at the end I can take one card from the row. And the question is what card to take. I definitely could take one of those technologies. Both of them have their situations where they actually could be useful, and I would score one science with Aristotle. For the drama, there's sadly no Bach in the game, but maybe Anthony Godi could be fine. There is the St. Peter's Basilica for a little bit of synergy, and also in the late game there's Marlene Dietrich, the Hollywood, so having the drama is maybe not too bad. But without Bach, it just takes quite a while until it maybe can get useful, and I have to be a little bit careful about hand space, which could be an issue when I take too many technologies. The warfare can of course also be fine, but I will go for the monarchy, have my third military action already, who knows, maybe I will even get Jan Šuška the next turn, and then I really don't need the warfare. And so at the end I actually ended up taking the reserves, just maybe also not that ideal, but I went for alchemies first, and in that case some additional resources are definitely welcome, also the flexibility to maybe also get an additional population out, and even though I don't score any science for Aristotle, I at the end was willing to take it, at least I can use it, and with that easily make space in my hand again, and the additional resources I thought could be quite helpful. I made the decision to actually discard the medieval army tactic, because at LC's next turn he might just go for the knights, maybe he won't go for the knights, and I will still be able to get them, but I just wanted to keep the two defense cards in hand. I also didn't want to reveal the tactic, because LC might then just go for knights, Jan Schuschka, and there could be a bit of trouble for me. I draw the raiders in the rebellion. What's near seats opens the development of politics, meaning I also got three additional draws. I have now another copy of Legion tactic and a strategic territory. Watsniets will increase his population, develops the code of laws, has still three signs left at least. He will interestingly take the drama, the rich land, the reserves and the frugality. Then he also will reveal the heavy cavalry tactic, and with having the reserves and the frugality now, maybe he can get enough population out to make the tactic work, which could give him quite a big amount of strength at some point. LC will seed and opens the development of science. He will go for the iron, goes for Jan Schuschka, actually builds one additional iron mine with having the hanging gardens. Maybe that is at the end justified, but he interestingly doesn't go for the knights, meaning it's now a little bit bad that I don't have the medieval army tactic any longer, but at least I can still go for the legion tactic, so that's maybe not that bad. And instead of the knights, LC just takes the patriotism for two, interestingly. But he has the fighting band tactic, that of course works also quite well with Jan Schuschka. Now it is my turn, and I made a decision to push the strategic territory, because I have two defense cards in hand. I will this turn develop the monarchy, giving me more draws from this turn on, and I was just hoping that maybe with those two defense cards I have a decent shot at winning the strategic territory, and if I should win it at the end, then maybe I am already somewhat nicely prepared for the Suez Canal with having that one colony, so I kind of wanted to push this into the deck, and then the other events are maybe not that great to push for me. The event revealed is the development of warfare, giving me one free warrior. I will go for the monarchy this turn, and then I have five civil actions left. And also I have to think about what leader I maybe want to go for, and I think there's a relatively clear answer which leader might be best. All of the leaders are on the row. Gutenberg is definitely not an option with me having already done one upgrade to alchemy. Action of Arc could be somewhat fine, but I don't have a religion and now already my third military action, and so I think Nostradamus is definitely very nice to have. The question is, do I have to take him now, or can I maybe wait for the next turn? And I think I have to take him now, because if I don't take him, I have to use some of my civil actions to take some cards. I just kind of have to. And then even if I maybe only take one of those three cards or something, or only one of those yellow cards, with there being those interesting yellow cards and Watsniets having a lot of civil actions, it's definitely possible that he would maybe take two more of those yellow cards, and then Nostradamus would be discarded before my next turn. So I think it's good to take him already this turn, but not only because he might be discarded, but also because, first of all, there's a chance that the age will end before my next turn, and also the event deck might be flipped before my next turn, meaning the strength from Nostradamus could be relevant, and if both of my opponents seed, then I would not have the full knowledge about the next event deck, so I think it's nice to take Nostradamus, but before I elect him, I can score a bit more science with Aristotle if I take one or maybe even two technologies. I made the decision to take the Bread and Circuses. There's Anthony Godi, there's Darwin, there's Pierre, so I think a lot of synergy. There was no development of religion revealed yet, so I think the perfect environment of taking the Bread and Circuses, especially with also scoring that one science with Aristotle. I could now just upgrade my lab and increase my population, but I also made a decision to also take the knights. I don't really plan to go for those in the near future, because I have the Legion tactic and the Swordsman, but it's not bad to maybe have them in hand, and now I can take them with scoring a science with Aristotle, so without Aristotle maybe I wouldn't take them, but with the additional science at the end I was willing to take them, and then I can go for Nostradamus, and with my last civil action I made a decision to upgrade this lab, and I thought my position is definitely quite decent. I have now very solid science production. I have some additional strength from Nostradamus. I score some additional culture from Nostradamus. At the moment, we are all very low in culture, but maybe I can get a little bit of a lead now with having Nostradamus. And then I was hoping that maybe I can then continue with building up my economy, making sure that I am not behind in strength, and then maybe I could get in a decent position. I will keep the two defense cards and the raiders. I will even draw another defense card, maybe increasing my chances that I will be able to win the strategic territory. And I also draw the phalanx tactic, which could be an alternative in order to, instead of going for the legion tactic. Vatsnitz reveals the development of religion, which I can take, but it's maybe also not ideal for me, because with having the bread and circuses, maybe it could have been better for me if instead of all players getting the free religion, no player gets the free religion, I can just go for bread and circuses, but it's maybe also not too bad. Vatsnitz this turn will start with going for knights. Also he seeded, and of course I saw what he seeded, which in this case was quite relevant knowledge, because he pushed the uncertain borders, so quite a big strength event, which also explains why he does go for those two knights already this turn. Maybe also just to use those military actions now in H1, and also maybe with not having that much else to do. And yeah, so that's definitely good knowledge for me that that event is in the deck. Then it's Elsie's turn. He will finish the Hanging Gardens, and he has to finish it now, otherwise it would be too late. Also, he will elect Jan Šiška, gets a bit of additional strength, gets a bit of additional culture, takes the swordsman, and then increases his population. But with being at 4 strength, he is still the weakest at my turn, meaning I can push without being in the danger of getting hit by the uncertain borders. And so I, even though if Vatsnitz goes for another knight, which he can do without having uprising issues, will be quite strong. I was willing, in order to get a 3 additional cash from Nostradamus, and maybe having the chance to push that event out before Elsie maybe gets stronger with Jan Šiška, I made a decision to push the raiders into the deck, especially because of the strategic territory being revealed might also be quite nice for me. And the event revealed is the good harvest, which no, makes it that after increasing my population I'm at 3 food, which is maybe not ideal, but at least I have a copy of reserves, so the 2 additional food will allow me, with combined with the reserves, to actually get an additional population out, which might definitely not be bad, because that could allow me to fulfill the legion tactic. The question is now, do I want to invest into military this turn, or do I maybe just focus on upgrading my economy, and that could mean maybe going for iron, for example, because I think it could be nice to, in the next turns, relatively quickly set up some iron production, because there are a lot of strong H2 wonders, and if you are waiting for the coal, I think it can be a bit more difficult to go for those H2 wonders. If I don't go for the iron, Vatsnitz could, with having the 2 rich lands, go for the iron immediately the next turn with the engineering genius, would very nicely be prepared to go for one of those H2 wonders if one of them will be available. And so I thought I definitely want to take the iron, and with me not being the weakest, I was willing to not increase my military. It could mean, of course, that when both of my opponents increase their strength, that I will be the weakest at my next politics phase, meaning I can't push without there being the risk of the uncertain borders being revealed. But I don't have an event in hand anyway. Who knows if I will draw one that I want to push. So at the end, I thought it's just the best maybe to get this iron production going now. And with my last civil action, I made a decision to take the irrigation, because there is an ocean liner service in the game, and then it can be used as a very cheap way to get out of famine issues. I will just keep all of the colonization cards, and I will draw another one and the vast territory, so maybe I can set myself up for a Suez Canal quite nicely, maybe winning the strategic territory and then having the vast territory available for the Suez Canal. I definitely was not unhappy to see it, but I probably don't want to push the vast territory, meaning I maybe have to wait with pushing at my next turn. Vatsnitz offers the open borders agreement to Elsie. And he, interestingly, will go for the railroad, which is definitely an interesting decision, then goes for the urban growth, builds one step with the engineering genius, and in order to get out of corruption will build an additional knight, is now at 11 strength. So an interesting decision by him to go for the railroad, but I think it could also be quite a strong decision. I mean, he could alternatively also just go for a yellow card, but while the railroad is a very expensive project for him, and he doesn't have any coal mines yet, he will very likely will be able to get go for a coal mine at some point, and then he maybe later in H2 once he managed to finish all of that will get a really big boost to his production, also to his strength, putting him making him maybe even a bit more dangerous. And instead of just taking yellow card, he spent some civil actions already to take this wonder, making it may that maybe he has some more free civil actions at the following turn. So an interesting decision, but definitely one that has some potential. Then it's Elsie's turn. He will actually cancel the Open Borders Agreement immediately. Maybe it makes the difference, or likely it makes the difference between him being able to defend against an aggression or not, because the additional military action would be useful for him, but no, maybe then he couldn't have defended. I have three H1 defense cards, so maybe it's not unlikely that Elsie doesn't have a lot of them, and so he will just go for a lot of those upgrades, is now at 8 strength, and grabs the constitutional monarchy for 3 civil actions, and allowing him to maybe do a revolution at the next turn. At my turn, I don't want to push, because I want to keep the territory for a potential Suez Canal, don't want to commit to that, and then this turn was actually quite a bit tricky for me, because I didn't really know what to do. I, as you can see, make the decision to go for an iron upgrade, but instead I could, for example, also play the reserves of food, increase my population, then maybe develop the swordsman, and then make sure that I get a bit stronger in order to not be in danger of getting hit by the uncertain borders. But it feels a little bit bad to invest into the swordsman when there's also a copy of Rifleman on the row, which I definitely like quite a bit more, but taking the Rifleman for expensive and then maybe going for building one, first of all, is not possible if I want to use the reserves. Or it's actually possible, I could take it, develop it, play reserves for food, increase my population, build... Or actually, I was missing one resource, I think, to build one Rifleman, so I could only go for an upgrade, which would not be enough to not be the weakest after my turn, which is not that ideal, so that would be quite bad. I could just take the Rifleman in hand, and then I don't want to go for Swordsman, of course, so that could be an idea. And or I just ignore the Rifleman and the Swordsman, maybe just take some cards like Urban Growth, Patriotism, but I also don't have that much hand space. So I have some issues at this turn, and also, so I was really thinking about what to do, and also I realized that I could potentially get in trouble if I'm not careful, and the question is if I do want to do anything about it, because Watsonietz has had his first draw of H2 cards, and if he goes for Napoleon at his next turn, he will be at 15 strength. If he has drawn a war already, which is not that likely but possible, then he could declare the war against me. Nostradamus strength doesn't help me against it. He could go up to 15 strength, and then that would be quite dangerous for me. When I, for example, take the Rifleman as a defensive measure against it, I can maybe build one, maybe make it that I can also upgrade one if I don't go for this upgrade, but then I have some issues to get out of corruption. I mean, maybe I can just develop the Rifleman, upgrade one, and then at the next turn I could build one. That would put me at plus 7 strength, so at 9, so if there's a war over territory, I would still lose 2 yellow tokens or 6 signs from the war over technology, and I really thought that if that should be happening, that could be a very, very big setback, and could maybe not be game over, but yeah, definitely a very big setback. So I was quite a bit afraid of that, and also if he goes for Napoleon later on, finishes the railroad, it again might get even more problematic. At the moment I don't have the most population, and it could be quite nice for me to maybe just focus on building up more economy, maybe have a chance to build a big Suez Canal, maybe have a chance to go for the ocean liner service, and if Watsonietz goes for something like that, it might completely distract me from all of that. Maybe he doesn't have the right cards anyway, maybe he won't go for Napoleon, but I was a little bit afraid, and as I didn't know what to do this turn anyway, at the end I actually decided to eliminate this danger and went for Napoleon myself. Which is definitely a bit of a questionable decision, but at least I do eliminate this danger. Watsonians, if he has a war, can maybe still declare one, but now I have a chance to get additional strength from Napoleon, so hopefully I should be safe from a war. And while Napoleon is not really doing for me that much, I still have a strong leader for myself with Nostradamus. Maybe I can keep him for most of H2. I still get a lot of value out of my leader, and with having Napoleon in hand, I always have the chance to threaten just a bit more strength, and with Watsonietz maybe finishing the railroad at some point, it could be quite relevant, especially, of course, now that he can't go for Napoleon, I'm a lot safer. And, so I, at the end, mainly as a safety measure, because I didn't really know what to do this turn, at the end went actually for Napoleon. And with my last two civil actions, I made a decision to increase my population, so that at the next turn maybe I can go for one legion tactic. For now, sadly, I'm the weakest, meaning I could get hit by the uncertain borders. So maybe instead of going for this upgrade, I could have developed a swordsman build one. But I thought maybe there's a chance that a rifleman could be available for me at the next turn. Watson Yates might go for them, but he might also want to do some other stuff and doesn't have that much hand space. If he wants to go for Republic and maybe a yellow card, he might leave the rifleman on the row, and else he might want to do revolution anyway. Has swordsman already, so I didn't want to commit to the swordsman. If I go for the rifleman, I can't go for Napoleon, and I might then be a bit in trouble. And so at the end, I made this decision at the end, so wasn't really certain about it. Instead of playing reserve for food and increasing my population, I could also take another yellow card, for example patriotism. But at the end, I thought maybe it's not too bad to increase my population. There could, for example, also be the reds in the deck. So yeah, at the end, that I came up with this turn, but I was not completely certain about it, and it didn't feel too great to pay 3 civil actions for Napoleon. I will get one more draw, 3 more draws in, another colonization card, so I'm really nicely prepared to maybe win the strategic territory, and now also some events that I can push, so I'm definitely quite a solid draw. Sadly, Watson Yates will try an aggression against me, an H1 blunder, which I definitely want to block. It could really benefit him a lot, maybe to finish the Transcontinental Railroad a little bit earlier, and so I definitely want to defend, even though it means that I have to sadly use a colonization card, which makes it maybe less likely that I will be able to win a colony. And also it was a bit of a tough decision what to discard actually, and as you actually can see, I discarded a vast territory. I could have also, instead of discarding 2 non-decolonization cards, I could have also just discarded 1 H1 colonization card, but that just would make it even more unlikely that I can win the strategic territory, which I didn't like. Then of course I really thought I might just want to keep 2 colonization cards in hand in the vast territory, but as when you take a look at the row, the ocean liner service is revealed. Watson Yates can't take it. Elsie could take it, but only if it falls down to 2, and then it would take it his whole turn. He would have corruption, he can't go for his revolution. So I thought, it's maybe not a bad chance that I can go for the ocean liner service at my next turn, and then I have already a strong wonder, and maybe don't necessarily have to be prepared for the Suez Canal any longer. It would maybe still be nice, even after the ocean liner service, to go for the Suez Canal, but once I have finished that, maybe the Suez Canal will already be gone. And also definitely has some benefits to maybe be able to see that the next turn the Ravages of Time. Maybe I also don't want to push because there is the danger of the uncertain borders being revealed, but there's also the hope of a colony being revealed, where I have bigger chances to win it when it is revealed on my turn. So I at the end actually made a decision to keep the Ravages of Time, especially because this event also can have the potential to do quite some damage, for example, against Elsie. And also Watson Yates, if he goes for Republic now, then losing the Colosseum and also the Happy Face might also be quite annoying for him. So I kind of wanted to keep this event at the end more than keeping my options open for the Suez Canal, because chances are that maybe at the next turn I have the chance to go for the ocean liner service. Watson Yates goes for the Republic, maybe wants to set himself up for a revolution, develops the drama because at the end of his turn he has a full hand, and then also takes the urban growth, and doesn't go for the Rifleman, meaning that maybe I have a chance to take them at my next turn. Elsie will just go for the revolution, meaning that both the Rifleman and the ocean liner service will be available for me at my turn. And with having Nostradamus, even though there is the danger of the uncertain borders being revealed, I at the end made a decision to push, just for the culture, because I wanted to get the Ravages of Time in, and because there at least also is the hope that a colony is revealed, and there is a colony revealed, but not the strategic territory that I've ceded. Instead, I inhabit a territory ceded by one of my opponents. I was willing to bid 1 warrior, I think, and both colonization cards. I think I was not willing to bid both warriors, because then I could really be in trouble of being able to defend against an aggression. So I could defend probably, but it would take a lot more effort. So I was happy to win it for just 1 warrior. But now I have no cards in hand and have to be quite a bit careful. I definitely want to go for the ocean liner service, and then I could, for example, maybe develop the rifleman, but And I would actually, oh no, I don't have enough to go for two of them, so I could maybe go for two swordsmen in order to defend. If I go for riflemen, I can't fulfill the tactics, so that's not ideal. Of course, I also can elect Napoleon, but for the against aggression, of course, Nostradamus' strength is helping as well, so it's also not that helpful to go for Napoleon. And at the end, I could also maybe go for the strategy, but then I have to miss out on the ocean liner service. At the end, I found a solution to just build those two warriors, take and develop the navigation. That makes it that with the one draw that I'm getting, I have just enough to defend against an aggression from Watsonyets. And there's the strategic territory coming, so the navigation definitely increases my chances to win this colony, and who knows, maybe I can at the end, if I, especially with the additional draws from the strategic territory, still have some hopes to get the Suez Canal going at some point. And then with my last civil action, I of course also wanted to get a rifleman. And I have just enough resources so that I can go for one more iron upgrade at the next turn, and then I have just enough resources to finish the ocean liner service in two turns, which was then mainly my plan now for the next turns. Watsonyets sees the event revealed is the uncertain border, so I definitely got lucky here with the timing, because that event could have also hit me at my turn. And Watsonyets this turn will go for the scientific method. There's still no copy of coal, but he wouldn't have enough science for it anyway, so maybe it's even quite nice for him that he can go for the scientific method now, getting some science production first. He can maybe go for another upgrade at the next turn with the urban growth, and he also takes the selective breeding to have a solution for his population at some point. Elsie will take the revolutionary idea, definitely can use some additional science, will increase his population, goes for one upgrade and even another upgrade. Now it's my turn, I can't use my politics phase this turn. Also, I think Watsonyets pushed one event into the deck, and that event is actually the developed territory too, so my navigation at the end might actually prove to be quite useful. This turn I want to upgrade my last mine, and then as I said, in the next turn I have just enough resource to finish the ocean liner service. And then this turn was a bit tricky to figure out, because there is at least a chance, it's not guaranteed, but there is the chance that my next turn could be the last one already in H2. Definitely also not unlikely that I have two more turns in H2, but it's possible at least that the next turn could be the last one. And it could potentially be nice to maybe get the irrigation out before the end of the age, and maybe also the bread and circuses to be prepared for Pierre. And But I also have a full hand. I thought about electing Napoleon now and then taking the justice system, developing it, giving me more hand space, but it also costs quite a bit of science, and then if I want to go for bread and circuses, irrigation, maybe a military tech, it could be a bit costly. And now, so it was a little bit tricky to figure this turn out, and also electing Napoleon doesn't give me that much benefit. I won't use a military action this turn, so I will get three draws in anyway, and with Nostradamus I have the chance to get more knowledge, and maybe I have the chance to seed at the next turn with getting his additional culture. The two strength on Napoleon would only matter if the foray would be revealed at Watsonyets' turn. For the other events, it wouldn't make any difference. So instead of electing him and making space in my hand like that, and then keeping me with enough science to go for the justice system this turn, I instead made a decision to develop a technology, went for the irrigation. There's still a copy of team spots, so I think it makes sense to commit to the irrigation instead of committing to the bread and circuses. And then I have not enough science left to go for the justice system, but enough for the architecture, which of course also is a bit of an investment. But it's also quite nice to use it in the ocean liner service and to maybe later on save some resources when going for some urban building, so I kinda liked it to go for the architecture here. I also took it away from Watsonyets, who can't go for it at the next turn, but could maybe still also save some resources and civil actions, so I could have also taken the other one, but I thought it was maybe a little bit nice to take it away from Watsonyets, and then I have two civil actions left. And I made a decision to take the urban growth and build one step of the ocean liner service. The architecture is definitely a bit of an investment, and if I want to develop the bread and circuses at the next turn, just to make sure that I have the technology available, then I would be at one science plus four, meaning I'm missing one science to go for something like rifleman, cannons, or maybe a military tech, which maybe could be needed if Watsonyets soon will finish the railroad. That could be a bit bad, but thanks to the urban growth, even though I need all of my resources to finish the ocean liner service, with the additional population that I'm getting, maybe I can just commit to an additional lab at the next turn, and then I would have actually six science available in two turns, and that could maybe be nice. In general, it could be nice to get some additional science production, so I thought that is a nice turn. Getting the urban growth also for one civil action, I think, is quite nice. Three additional resources, and so I went for this turn, keeping Nostradamus, having the architecture, being able to get the Bread and Circuses out guaranteed before the age will end if I want to, and then still being able to get them go for military tech in two turns. Sadly, I don't draw an event, so Nostradamus won't give me any additional culture, and as you also can see, there is actually the Frey on top. So sadly, I didn't have knowledge about this event, so in hindsight, electing Napoleon would have been actually the better decision, but there was only one event that I didn't have knowledge about, so I think it was still the right decision to keep Nostradamus, but of course, it's a bit bad to miss out on those additional resources. Sadly, now Watznitz and Elsie will both be able to get them, and Watznitz this turn might be able to get a very nice boost for himself. Goes for Robespierre, does a very cheap revolution, and with doing this, he has now his government farm going, but he still has enough science left to easily get into coal in the next turn, takes those yellow cards, can easily go for two coal upgrades in two turns, maybe finish the railroad, and then his position out of the sudden maybe explodes a little bit, having a lot of civil actions, having maybe something like 10 resource production once he has finished the railroad after going for those two upgrades. So if he can go for coal at the next turn, his position really might explode, and there we can see the potential of going for the railroad earlier on. It seemed a little bit weird. He was just sitting on those bronze mines, slowly investing into the first steps, then started a little bit of scientific method production. But with being able to go for this Robespierre revolution, and then soon, maybe with all of those yellow cards quickly getting into coal, I was quite a bit afraid that his position could get a bit too strong, but at least I have the ocean liner service, that is also not bad, and with the Bread and Circuses might be prepared for Pierre, so I also have some nice stuff going for myself. Elsie this turn will go for the alchemy, wants to get a bit of additional science production. It's quite a late alchemy actually, but the scientific method is just not available, and he maybe just wants to spend some actions on actually doing some investments instead of just taking some cards, and also get some out of corruption. But it's also of course not ideal to maybe invest into the alchemy that late. He then takes the cavalryman Darwin, and then adopts the Legion tactic. And with the last civil action, will elect Darwin, so Shishka is now retired, and he will play the revolutionary idea. Now it is my turn. I will this turn go for Napoleon, because at the next turn the age will now very likely end. Both of my opponents have taken some cards from the row, with Watznitz being able to go for this revolution and then taking those yellow cards, Robespierre. So now it is actually quite likely that the age will end, meaning I will go for Napoleon, and if I want to have the Bread and Circus available, I have to develop them now. Could also wait for the team sports, but that technology by I might really taken by Elsie if he has the chance to go for it, so I think I kinda have to develop the Bread and Circuses this turn, but first of all, of course, I also want to finish the ocean liner service thanks to the architecture for only one civil action. I will take the breakthrough, that's just too good of a card to take for one civil action, especially because I have maybe a little bit of science issues, and then I have to make space in my hand. We'll do that with going for Bread and Circuses. We'll also go for building as said the third lab. I also thought about building a Bread and Circuses, but I think just the additional science might be very useful, and then I can also take the efficient upgrade with my last civil action, which can be very nicely used to maybe go for an upgrade now out of one of the following turns to upgrade this lab to alchemy, or maybe to upgrade a farm to irrigation. Of course, in both of those cases, I only used for two resources, but it's again, take it for one civil action, and it might still be a nice deal. And who knows if there are maybe computers or something, or maybe an early oil, even though maybe I don't have enough science to support an early oil, then I can maybe also use it for the full three resources, and with my last civil action I increase my population normally, so with not building the Bread and Circuses I might potentially be in danger of some happy face related events, but I know that the top event is no happy face related event, and instead the strategic territory. Sadly, the Suez Canal will be gone. I had some small hopes that maybe if I draw a colony with the strategic territory, that maybe I have still the chance to go for the Suez Canal, but Watznitz will go for the coal and it will now be discarded. And I didn't want to only for that small hope, not take the efficient upgrade to maybe make the chances a little tiny bit bigger that this rule scanner could still be around for me at the next turn, because finishing it will also take again quite some resources and it might just be too late at the end then. So that was my turn. Instead of increasing my population, I could have also taken the reserves, but then the cannons fall down to 2 civil actions for Watson Yates. If he takes them anyway, then I just give him 1 civil action, but it could also actually make the difference for him whether he takes them or not, and then it could make quite a difference for me, because I don't have a tactic yet. I missed out on the cavalry man, and I won't developing the knights. I don't have the science for that, so it could be quite bad if I miss out on the cannons and could potentially leave me quite vulnerable. So with that, I didn't want to take 2 of those cards, and at the end rather went for the efficient upgrade, because I don't need to spend additional civil action to use it. Even though the reserves could also be useful, maybe also help me to get out of famine, even though I have the irrigation, so for that I don't really need it, but but then I have to spend 2 resources for 3 2 civil actions for 3 resources, so I still think spending 1 for 2 is the better deal, even, and there is also the chance at least that I can maybe still also spend it for 3 resources. I draw some cards. The terrorism could potentially be interesting. At the moment it's very close, but depending on what the others will do and how nicely I will maybe be able to build up some culture or not, it could be an interesting event to see it. And also I get 1 more colonization card, which could actually help me to win the strategic territory that is on top. And it will be revealed now by Watson Yates, meaning that sadly there's 1 event that I don't have knowledge about. Also, I think I forgot to tell you about 1 more event that Watson Yates seeded, the Independence Declaration. And thanks to the colonization card, I am able to win this colony for Just a Warrior, which I definitely was happy about and was of course interested to see what I will draw, maybe giving me the chance to get an H2 tactic. Sadly no tactic, but the international trade agreement is of course not bad to have and could give me some additional value. And what's next this turn will go for the coal. With playing the reserves, he can use both of the H1 rich lands before he will lose them to the end of the age, and that the next turn can finish the railroad. And thanks to the rich land, could also still go for an upgrade to selective breeding, and maybe even 2. So he definitely has some strong options for the next turn, but he isn't taking the cannons, so I, with both of the cannons being the Rono, have the chance to go for those cannons. Sadly, the raiders that I've seeded earlier on with Nostradamus will backfire now quite a bit, because I have no food to lose, meaning losing 2 resources in this position, I think, is actually quite a bit hurtful. Elsie also, I think, had to lose 2 resources, but he at least has a bit more resources available. He this turn will go for the selective breeding, will also take the cannons for 1 civil action with Darwin, the frugality, and then will just go for 2 upgrades, making sure that he gets a bit of population income, but he might have an issue at the next turn, because he is missing 1 food once he will lose the 2 yellow tokens in order to increase his population, and then he might have an uprising issue. There is the hope for him that he might get a team sports, but the problem for him is that Watson Yates also doesn't really have a happy face solution, and with that, maybe it could be taken away, so that could be a bit of an issue for him. Now we will be entering H3, so we can maybe take a quick look at the overview. I was not unhappy about my position, but also not really that confident. I was really fearing that Watson Yates was going up to 10 resource production soon, having that many civil actions, might at the end just have too strong of a position, and it could be difficult to finish before him. I have 1 big main advantage against him, however, and that is the population. I have the ocean liner service, have already 2 free population lying around, while Watson Yates doesn't have any population ongoing, doesn't have the greatest yellow bank, and also once he will lose the Colosseum to the Ravages of Time, could have a little bit of happy face issues. That could be 1 advantage that I have over him, and maybe if I get the right military cards in H3, that could be a nice way to maybe punish that. But I don't have those cards yet, and so it could be a bit tricky, but I also am prepared for Pierre, who can do really some nice stuff if I'm just able to spam some 2 resource bread and circuses. That could be very nice. So I felt that it could be difficult to finish before Watson Yates in this game, but definitely possible, of course. But I felt that maybe I have an advantage over Elsie, with having the ocean liner service, having the architecture developed, and just having similarly strong reduction, Elsie having the selective breeding instead of the ocean liner service, which is probably a bit worse. But Elsie actually might get some very big troubles potentially soon, because their team spots are on the row. I thought that Watsonians might take them, because having the team spots would also set them up for Pierre as a leader, and he might need a happy face solution anyway, especially if maybe the Ravages of Time is revealed before his turn. He very likely will go for that. And if then there is no bro spot revealed, else he has to dispense something. And if things go even worse, the Ravages of Time could be revealed before his turn, and then things could really fall apart for him, because then he would have to destroy lots of stuff. But of course, there can be a bro spots revealed. Maybe Watsonius won't go for the team spots, but there is at this point, LC's position is a little bit fragile because of the event coming, and depending on what happens, he could get a bit into trouble. But if he fixes that, then his position is probably somewhat solid. But I was thinking that with me having the ocean liner, the architecture, and a bit more science production at the moment, at least, I was hoping that maybe I have at least a good position against him, but against Watsonians I thought it might end up being difficult. I, at the end, made a decision to offer the international trade agreement to Elsie. It was also a little bit of a decision, do I want to play for second or first place, and I wasn't really certain, but I was hoping that with the team spots taken away, maybe there could be some issues for Elsie, and also he has to do those investments into the team spots, and can't then maybe invest elsewhere, or just some science gone, some resource gone, especially the science might be relevant. So I was hoping that maybe I have good chances to finish at the second position, and maybe then I can play this pact without Watsonians being involved, maybe increasing my chance by a little bit to play for the first place, but I could have maybe also offered it to Watsonians. But as said, his main downside is being low in population, and I kind of didn't want to help him out with that, and at the end offer this pact to Elsie. I will this turn, of course, use the ocean liner service, and one civil action, or one thing that I definitely want to do is taking those cannons. Sadly, I don't have a tactic for them, but I really need them in hand to at least threaten a tactic, and who knows, if I get something like entrenchments or positional army, I definitely could have some potential with all of the population that I'm having to go for quite a nice military. So the cannons, I think, is something that I definitely want to have, and also what I wanted to do is to build one Breton Circuses, because there's one unknown event in there, and it could potentially be emigration or civil unrest, and also one of the known events in there is the independence declaration, and the Breton Circuses not only fixes my happy faces but also makes it that I'm not the weakest at after my turn. So I think that has just too much use case. Of course, in order to get stronger I could also build a warrior, but with not knowing what tactic I will be getting, I'm kind of wanted to avoid it, to already commit another population into the infantry, and found it nice that I can fix my happy face issues, me being the weakest with just going for Breton Circuses while also fixing my happy face issues. Then I have three civil actions left, and I also made a decision to use the sufficient upgrade now, just getting a bit more science production in. The science could be very useful. Blue technologies like civil service or military theory could be very nice to get. Maybe if I am able to save up enough science for an H3 government form, that could be quite strong, like democracy. So I really wanted to increase my science production immediately. There could be an argument for not using the efficient upgrade, because then I still have it in hand, and there is the chance at least that I can use it for three resources later on instead of only two. And I am basically guaranteed to also use it for two resources later on, with me as wanting to go for this farm upgrade. And if I go, for example, for computers, then it could be nice, and maybe it will save me one resource at the end, having the sufficient upgrade not used yet. But then I would keep it in hand, and I will take one more card from the row, meaning I have almost a full hand, and there could actually be the Ravages of Time revealed before my next turn. Once this is revealed, I'm down to 5 civil actions, which I was a bit worried about. Also a reason why I wanted to get this upgrade in, because having some science will maybe open up some options for me to get more civil actions, either with the civil service or the democracy maybe. And and if the Ravages of Time is revealed before my next turn, then I would have a full hand. I can, of course, easily make space in my hand with maybe just using the efficient upgrade and on a farm upgrade, but if there are some important cards, it could be a bit annoying, and so I just wanted to get rid of this now, and because I might only use it for two resources at the end anyway. For the last two civil actions, I said that I will take one card, but there is also the option to take two cards. The main decision for me here was between taking the wave of nationalism, which could really give me a lot of resource for the military, and in case I draw some interesting cards, maybe get a copy of military theory or something, then having six additional resource for the military could be quite strong. But also if maybe one of the other players pushes for a bit more military, what's needs with having the railroad, and if I want to go for a new leader like Pierre, then having a way to get additional resources to build additional military units could also be quite nice. But alternatively, I could go for another efficient upgrade, which I then at least can guaranteed use for two resources on those farm upgrades. And I could take the opera, which would prepare me for Marlene Dietrich, Chaplin, potentially Fleming. Maybe I can even make something like the Hollywood work. I can build them for six resources. So it could be an idea. But again, I would have a full hand then if the Ravages of Time is revealed before my next turn. And so at the end, I just ended up taking the wave of nationalism. And maybe I can hope to go for something like movies at some point. I will get my first H3 draw, which is maybe a fine draw. Sadly, I get a tactic, but one that would be quite difficult to use, because I would have to build a lot of tanks, which is quite expensive. So sadly, still not a really usable tactic, but at least Impact of Harmony, and with me having the Oceanliner service, there's the potential that I maybe can make this impact relatively big at the end, so at least one potentially nice impact. Then Watsnir seats and opens the independence declaration, so me getting stronger was definitely relevant, otherwise I would have to lose one of my colonies now. Watsonites will now go for one upgrade to selective breeding, will go for another one, and will actually delay finishing the railroad, but he can easily do it, because sadly, after my turn, there was Bill Gates revealed, and I think that is really strong now for him. He doesn't really need Robespierre anyway, any longer. I mean, the military action is still somewhat useful, but now switching to Bill Gates, going up to 11 resource production once he finishes the railroad, being at 14 resource production, is quite bad. And sadly, now that he spends 3 civil actions on Bill Gates, he makes the decision that it's quite important for him to have the modern infantry. However, sadly, that means that he doesn't take the team spots for himself, and instead leaves that card for Elsie, which will definitely help him. He doesn't have to destroy anything now. And I was definitely a bit unhappy about those developments. Watsonius getting a strong leader, and that maybe also leading to him not taking the team spots, which helps Elsie. So I was a little bit worried about in which direction this game is heading. Especially Watsonius, I thought, will now be really difficult to finish before with him getting this early Bill Gates. Then it's Elsie's turn, he will go for the team spots. He has to do this if he doesn't want to destroy anything, that also gets him out of corruption. Then he takes the modern infantry for one civil action, meaning that the copy is gone for me, but I have riflemen anyway, and that prepares now Elsie for H3 tactics nicely, and then with the last two civil actions, he interestingly will go for the Harvard College actually, which is quite a late Harvard College, but he can maybe finish it at the next turn, and then maybe it could still be useful. He is really low in science, and maybe the science could still be useful, but it is also quite late. But maybe he didn't have that much else to do with the last two civil actions, and then maybe it's still quite nice to go for the Harvard College. Now it is my turn. I am the weakest. But the two events that I have knowledge about are no strength events, and so I was at the end willing to push the Impact of Harmony into the deck, hoping that it will be a nice impact for me. With the Wave of Nationalism, I can relatively cheaply build some military units, and then it should be already a fine impact for me. But before seeding, I had to really think about if losing the pyramids and the civil action from it affects my turn in a negative way, because if it does, then I probably shouldn't seed here. And this turn was really difficult for me to figure out, because in this turn I might really be defining in which direction I will go in this game, and what outs I may be playing towards, or which approach I will take. And there are some interesting cards in the row. There's the military theory and the civil service. Maybe you can let the event resolve first, but of course I had to think about this turn before seeding. But now the Ravages of Time is revealed. I will lose one civil action, but I figured basically my turn out before making the decision, and came to the conclusion that it's fine to lose the civil action now, and I was willing to see it. So I will use the Oceanliner service, and now one turn that I did consider was to just take the military theory, develop it, and then take the revolutionary deal. For that, I would have needed a pyramid. But that could have been an interesting turn. I would have had the military theory. I have the revolutionary idea, and with having the revolutionary idea, hopefully I have enough science to support going for something like riflemen, cannons, and also air forces, meaning that I could maybe set myself up for quite a threatening amount of strength, but I can only do this when I get the right cards. I need a tactic, and I would need a war, and I don't really know if I will get those things. And so that would be quite a big of a commitment if I go for this and don't get the right cards. Then I would be stuck on 5 civil actions maybe for a while, maybe not really, because I could of course also, with the revolutionary idea, maybe have enough science to go for an H3 government form at some point, but it could be a bit bad to be stuck on such low civil actions, and if I don't find the right cards to go for a military push maybe, then I could be not that nicely prepared for a peaceful game, but there is also a nice solution for me getting from that gives me more civil actions, and that is the civil service that is in the row. So I thought about taking civil service, developing it, getting more civil actions immediately. That gives me a very nice benefit, I think, and makes my position quite a bit stronger economically. But even if I don't see it and keep the pyramid, sadly I'm missing one civil action to then take both the military theory and the revolutionary idea. If I only take the military theory, then it's a very big science investment, and unless I very quickly get one or maybe even two more copies of revolutionary idea, it's quite unlikely that I would still be able to develop all of the military techs in time in order I do get the right cards. So I would shut down the military option at least quite a bit, maybe not totally. There are still some chances that I would be able to pull something off, but it would be quite difficult. But if I take the civil service and miss out on the military theory, take the revolutionary idea, then of course it's also quite difficult to go for something military heavy, because the first copy of military theory is gone. Watznitz will definitely go for it, and I really didn't like him getting the military theory, because he will lose the Colosseum now, and he will be stuck on two military actions, and I thought maybe one way to have chances against him is if I leave him with some weaknesses, and at the moment one weakness is maybe still the population, even though Ficarus has some production now, but he will lose the happy face, and that could be a bit annoying, so that could be an issue. And if he also is on low military actions, maybe that would cause enough trouble for him that maybe I can potentially overtake him, especially if I, for example, get Pierre very quickly, or maybe still go for a bit of a threatening amount. So I really didn't like giving military theory to Watznitz, and if I don't take it, it's also quite likely that maybe Elsie could take the second copy with Darwin at some point, and then I also don't really have any big hopes to going for the military. So at the end, it basically came down to a decision between either going for military theory and maybe revolutionary idea, maybe also without it. But either I go for something where, if I get the right cards, have really good chances to actually pull something off with my with having enough science and to go for all of it, or I go for an approach that leaves me economically a lot more solid, but makes it very difficult for me to go for a military push. But with me having neither a tactic nor a war, I at the end made the decision to rather go setting up for a strong economy, went for the civil service. Maybe I could just leave the military theory to Watznitz, but if he goes for military theory and railroad, I might actually be a little bit in danger, and so I sadly made the decision that I have to miss out on a revolutionary idea, go for the military theory. I have still enough science to develop it at the next turn, but going for military theory, some military techs, and then maybe air forces will be quite difficult, so pulling something off with the military might be quite difficult from now on, and to also be even more nicely prepared for also some peaceful options, I made a decision with my last civil action to grab one copy of movies, also taking one card away from Watznitz, where he can maybe spend the big resource production on that he will be having, and also setting myself up for leaders like Chaplin, maybe Marlene Dietrich, and potentially the Hollywood. So that was my solution at the end, but now sadly it will now be very difficult to go for something with the military, but I'm not stuck on 5 civil actions, and I was hoping that with having the setup and the population that I will be having, I have good chances to maybe finish at the second position, and maybe then also could, maybe there is still a chance that I could maybe get some revolutionary ideas, and with that maybe have some chances to also do something with the military still. But it was quite a tricky decision for me, and I was not too happy about the decision, but I also didn't find any other decision that I was really happy with. Then I will get some draws in, and I was regretting it maybe a little bit that I went for this play with the civil service, because now I actually have two strong tactics available. I don't have a wall yet, but maybe I went with the wrong path with getting those tactics, but getting those is not that likely, so that of course we know only in hindsight. And also sadly I saw something that I wasn't too happy about, because Pierre is actually revealed immediately after my turn, and with Elsie having the team spots he might get Pierre now. I will be missing out on Pierre, and I was not too happy about all of the developments in this game. Waltz Nils will this turn finish the railroad, goes for some dramas to fix his happy face, has to destroy a mine, but is still on 13 resource production, also has a bit of culture production going now. Elsie this turn will use the frugality, get some population going, takes the military theory with Darwin. With that, it is for certain now that Waltz Nils will be missing out on it, maybe staying on two military actions for quite a bit longer. And then Elsie will go for Pierre. Elects him, builds one more team spot, is now at 6 culture production, will get the Olympic Games, and I will definitely be falling a bit behind in culture now. And the next turn again was quite a bit tricky, but one decision that I made is that I want to see the terrorism, because now with LC and Watsonians both increasing the culture production, and me at the end figuring out a turn where I probably should stay a little bit behind in culture for the next one or two turns, I thought the terrorism is maybe the value that I can get out of it is maybe something that I need in order to not fall behind, because with Elsie getting Pierre and not getting in some nice impacts that could be helpful. I mean, I have the impact of Harmony already, so that's not bad, and at least I have a tactic that I can use now to defend myself. But my confidence that I can maybe have good chance to finish at the second position definitely got a little bit less after Elsie was now able to get Pierre, and which means that I won't be able to get Pierre, but of course it was always probably a bit more likely that Elsie would be the one to get Pierre with being right in front of me. And now the question is what to do this turn, and I said first of all I seeded a terrorism into the deck, the civil undress is revealed, which I was happy to see, it's the event that I don't have knowledge about, and I will actually end my turn with having one unhappy worker, so at least don't get punished with that event being the last one in the deck. I will use the ocean liner service, I don't want to have famine, and I have a relatively easy way to fix it, so I definitely want to do this. And then, the question is what to do this turn. There are some leaders in the road, it could be interesting. And if I don't go for one of those leaders, there's Marlene Dietrich and Chaplin left, meaning I probably would have to go for something like movies, but it could also take a while until those will be available, and with me probably not being able to go for a big military push, maybe it is nice to change for a new leader now, that gives some nice value now, and there is Mandela, the civil action from him, and the possibility to get some additional culture, I think is quite nice, so I tried out some turns with going for Mandela, and then maybe just going for a bunch of cheap red and circuses, or maybe going for professional sports. I could maybe also build a movie, however I have to be a bit careful about my science, because I still didn't invest into any military techs yet, and what's near, I could maybe get a fundamentalism at his turn. I didn't really find a free civil actions to deny that, which sadly gives Watsonitz a way to get some additional military actions, and if he then maybe also gets the Manhattan Project or something at some point, I could still get a little bit difficult, and even with using all of my science from now on for military techs, at the next turn, at this turn I can develop the military theory, at the next turn the cannons, and two turns the rifleman, meaning I can't really spend any science on something else without leaving myself quite a bit dangerous, which I didn't like. And just going for Mandela and some Brandon Circuses I also didn't really like that much. So I was not really certain what is best here, but I came to the conclusion that it is probably quite strong to go for the computers. That allows me to spend some science, sets me up nicely for some impacts, and will maybe still pay off until the end when I go for some upgrades now, and then going for those computers also takes them away from what's near, and I don't have to use any population for it, leaving me with a lot of free population that I can put wherever I want, and hopefully I would still enough science to go for all of those military things to not leave me very vulnerable. So I ended up taking the computers, and if I go for the computers, of course it could be quite nice to go for Sid Meier. But if I go for Sid Meier, then Now, I might have a little bit of a problem with my civil actions, because I can now develop the computers, and if I then spend one civil action to take Sid Meier, I can only go for two upgrades, which is not bad. Maybe I could do this. Maybe also keep Sid Meier in hand for one more turn if I need the science, because I really need the science, actually. But the problem is, I might even need more science than when I go for two upgrades, because when I go for two upgrades, I will be at plus 12. I have invested 8, so I have 3 plus 12 is 15, meaning at the next turn I don't have enough to go for military theory and one of those military attacks, meaning if I want to increase my strength, which I really want to do, because I want to use the wave, and it could be nice to get stronger because there might be some strength events, also for the impact of harmony that also could be revealed in the near future. I mean, it probably takes still a little while, but maybe if all of the opponents eat a lot, could also be revealed quite quickly, and then it could be nice to already start building military units at my next turn, but if I build them without having the military theory developed, I will miss out on some draws, and I think with going for the computers, I might really need a lot of draws, because I might, in order to display being rewarded, might need some nice impacts. And so I kind of liked it to have as much science to go for military theory and cannons. But in order to do this, I actually have to go for three computers upgrades, which doesn't leave me with enough civil actions to also take Sid Meier. I could, of course, maybe not do the farm upgrade, take four culture, lose four culture to famine. Maybe that could be an option, but I then also, in order to have the science, can't elect Sid Meier immediately, and at the end, I made a decision instead of going for Sid Meier, who, of course, has some nice potential with going for those computers, but maybe the science could actually also be helpful to not lose, especially because maybe it could also then allow me to later on still go for something like democracy. There's also a space flight where it could be nice to have as much science as possible. So at the end, I made a decision to instead go for Mandela, because him giving the civil action back immediately will allow me to go for him and still go for the three upgrades to computers. But before electing him, I will build a warrior using the military action from Napoleon. I will keep the positional army tactic in hand for that. It's at least somewhat useful. Not really, because two warriors are enough. But I just didn't want to be in danger of an aggression after I elect Mandela, which I would be if I don't build this warrior. And then I can go for two upgrades. It felt bad to just go for three upgrades, because that leaves me quite low on resources. And it could be quite nice to take maybe the urban growth or the engineering genius with the last civil action. But then again, at the next turn, it would be quite strong to maybe be able to go for military theory and something like cannons. And with that, I at the end made a decision to even just go for the third upgrade. At least I have the wave of nationalism, at least I have 8 civil actions, and there's still a lot of reserves in the deck that I can maybe get at one of the following turns, but of course now I have the chance to get the yellow card very efficiently. So I was, again, as in the turn before, not really certain about my decision. Maybe I shouldn't go for computers at all. Maybe I should just go for a bunch of brand circuses, but then I really need basically all of my science just to develop military theory, cannons, and riflemen over the following turns. And at least with the computers I have the potential to be quite nice for a bunch of impacts. And I have a lot of science, maybe can potentially go for a big space flight, and I go for Mandela immediately, putting me 29 culture, still with hopefully low enough culture production to not get hit by the terrorism. But I have now also invested a lot of resources, leaving me a bit inflexible, so I wasn't really certain about this decision, but at the end it was what I was going with. Then I will draw the impact of competition and two colonization cards. Colonization cards could be nice to have, because the last event on top is actually the developed territories 2 seeded by Vatsniets. But sadly no nice impact. The impact of competition with LC having those arenas is not looking really that great for me. Maybe if I build two cannons or something, it could still be somewhat fine at the end. The developed territory is revealed. I was willing to bid one warrior and two colonization cards, not more. Sadly, it is not enough. I was not willing to be in danger of an aggression at LC's turn, and LC also has some colonization cards, so he is able to win this colony. Vatsniets will go for the engineering, increases population, blazed reserves for food, increases population again, will go for one drama, will go for an additional lab, takes the fundamentalism and the bros parts, so has no happy face solution, has a way to get more military actions, and maybe could go for the Manhattan Project at the next turn, and then I have to be a little bit careful, but at the next turn I can at least go for cannons and military theory, and that maybe leaves me in a somewhat safe spot. Elsie will now finish the Harvard College, it is now indeed quite late, so I'm not sure if it was still worth it, but on the other hand, the science might still be useful for him, so... And also gets a little bit of additional culture, so maybe it is still somewhat fine, but it's definitely very late. He will now go for the engineering genius and the patriotism. Copies the fighting band tactic. And at my turn, I kinda want to continue seeding. First of all, because it could mean that the terrorism is revealed more early. Of course, I have to be careful, but if I don't increase my culture production at my next turn, then when I get 2 culture for seeding the arms industry, I would be 31 plus 5, 36. So I would have just enough as Elsie, and at Watsonia's turn, I would lose the tiebreaker against Elsie, but for the terrorism, it's of course good to be considered with having less culture, so I can push and then still win the terrorism, and I thought it could be nice to get the terrorism out quickly, then the impact of it might be bigger. So, and I also thought I might maybe need to take a bit of a risk and get as much culture as I can get in order to not fall behind too much in culture. And so I seeded the arms industry into the deck. However, the event that is revealed will change my plans a little bit, because it is actually the Dark Ages, which will make all the players lose quite a bit of science. Sadly, the investment into computers is definitely a bit worse than that now, and now I actually don't have enough to go for military theory and military tech anyway at this turn, meaning that I maybe could have taken the urban growth, maybe could have gone for Sid Meier, so I wasn't too happy about seeing those Dark Ages, but at least my opponents also lost some science to it. I will use the ocean liner service this turn, and the question is of course what to do now. There's a copy of Air Force, maybe I should be careful and take it, because there's the Manhattan Project, and if Watson jetzt goes for fundamentalism and Manhattan Project, he has definitely not a low amount of strength, but with having the positional army tactic, maybe I can be somewhat fine in the military theory, and also I think I need some additional resources, and maybe I have to take the risk at it, because there is still the hope at least that I get a second copy, and so I think I need to take some risks here, and I even thought it could maybe be safer to take the Air Force, made a decision against it here. And instead, I developed a military theory. I don't want to invest into cannons and missing out on some draws, because in order for this computer's play to pay off, I maybe need at least one good impact. So, impact of science, progress would be very strong. And also impact of technology, of course, could be nice. And also some other impacts could be nice for me. So I really wanted to make sure to get all of my draws in, meaning I have to wait with going for cannons and riflemen, but at least I have enough science to go for both of them at the next turn, not leaving me too vulnerable at least. And then I made a decision that I definitely want to have the additional resource from the reserves. I made a decision that I want to take a wonder now, because if I don't go for the fast food chains, then the space flight could be taken away and I might end up without any wonder, which maybe wouldn't be even too bad, because I can maybe also just prepare myself for impacts, build a movie or something, but maybe at the end it's still just better to go for this wonder, and with having the ocean liner service, and if I get some cheap military units with the wave, maybe build one additional farm or something, that could make the fast food chains actually also quite a decent wonder, so I wanted to have this. Sadly, I'm missing now one civil action to take even another copy of reserves, but I have another way to get at least a little bit of additional resource going, and that is with going for the efficient upgrade. Likely, I only will be able to use it for one farm upgrade, but at least it would still give me 2 resources for 1 civil action instead of, for example, taking the urban growth for 4 resources for 3 civil actions. And then I also took the rockets, just to have maybe one more cheap technology to develop. And that's the end of my turn. I was hoping for some impact. Sadly, I don't get any impacts. A war I would have now, so... Going for the military theory play and not going for civil service early on could have maybe been the better decision. Of course, we don't know what would have happened. The card draw movement would have been different, but I would have had at least the chance to get a nice tactic and a war going by now. But who knows if that would have worked out. But sadly, I don't get any really nice impacts going. Watson yet seats, sadly there's no terrorism revealed, instead international negotiations, at least with me developing the military theory, I'm not the weakest, so Elsie will lose something from that and has to pay 3 signs to Watson yet. Watson yet this turn will indeed go for the Manhattan Project, will just finish that wonder, will also go for the fundamentalism, is now at 35 strength, is definitely a bit threatening, maybe preventing his opponents from doing something useful. Will then interestingly disband a unit of knights, but maybe he does need it anyway to fulfill this classic army tactic at some point, and then will just go for an additional theater and maybe can disband his knight this turn without missing out on a draw and just do it, does it this turn, even though he could have also just kept it because he has a free population at the end of his turn. So an interesting move. He doesn't go for the air forces, so my decision to not take them has definitely paid off, and I can take one only for one civil action at the next turn if I want to. Elsie will build one more team spot, takes the revolutionary idea, plays it, goes for the air forces, develops the cavalryman and ends his turn, and sadly he didn't push, meaning that the terrorism is still on top, and I have the problem that I have no nice card to see it, only the impact of competition, which is definitely not great for me and will be nice for Elsie, who at this point was definitely the opponent that I was mainly looking for, because Watson Yates, I just thought, will have good chances to win anyway, and if I can overtake one of my opponents, it's probably Elsie, but now I have to make a tough decision. Do I not push, delay the terrorism, which would probably make its impact a little bit less big. I mean, maybe the opponents will even build even more expensive buildings, but I thought it might have a bigger impact if it is revealed now, because, for example, if one of my opponents wants to grab the space flight, that will require a lot of civil actions. Maybe then they can't rebuild the building immediately, and that could then result in even a bit more of a loss. And it was a really tough decision, because I will go for 2 cannons, I will build some bread and circuses, so I will improve my impact of competition at least by a little bit, but if Elsie also uses his patriotism with his many populations, just maybe builds 2 cavalrymen in order to copy the classic army tactic or something at some point, then his impact of competition is definitely quite a bit bigger, but there is another reason why it is nice to maybe seed, and that is that then there are some chances that the impact of harmony is revealed quickly, because I will improve my impact of harmony this turn, but Elsie at this point has still a very bad harmony, it's only a harmony of 8, but this next turn there is the chance that he might build some units, and that would improve his impact of harmony by quite a bit, and with both of those reasons combined, I at the end made a tough decision to seed this impact of competition into the deck, in order to get the terrorism out now, and in order to increase the chances that the impact of harmony is revealed before Elsie's turn. So I can destroy 2 things, destroying 1 lab from Valsinets and 1 arena from Elsie. I will use the ocean liner service during my turn, and then I again have to think about what to do. I definitely need to develop both cannons and riflemen to not be too much in danger. I will reveal the position army tactic. I mean, with having the rockets, I could also don't necessarily have to develop the cannons, but I want to build more military units for the impact of harmony, and the rockets are just a bit too expensive, maybe. Still want to be able to finish the fast food chains, so I went for this. Revealing the positional army tactic makes me the weakest, so that I can use the wave of nationalism for the full 6 resources. And then I will build 2 cannons, getting a bit stronger, preparing at least a little bit for the impact of competition, and more importantly also for the impact of harmony. And then I have some civil actions left, and will, with my last civil actions, just take the air forces, making me a bit safer that there aren't any bad surprises. Maybe it could also be fine to not take it, and then I will take the urban growth, the reserves, build 1 arena, build another arena, getting a bit of additional culture production going, preparing myself again for the impact of competition, and also some other impacts like happiness. And at the next turn have just enough resource to, for example, go for 1 movie, but there might also be a democracy available, in which case it might be better to go for the democracy and maybe get some culture production or impact preparation going at the same time with the resources that I have available after finishing the fast food chains. And I have again 3 draws, so at this point thought, I really need now 1 good impact, otherwise it's really looking not that great. Or then I might have to hope that Watson Yates maybe seeds a nice impact for me into the deck. But sadly, I again don't get an impact, instead more walls. So sadly this game I'm not blessed with impact draws, and now I Now, was definitely worried about the outcome of this game, and also Watson yet doesn't see it, meaning it is now possible that the impact of Harmony maybe isn't revealed before Elsie's turn, which would be a bit bad for me. Watson yet will go for the Hollywood, goes for the multimedia, the space flight wasn't on the road during his turn, meaning he just goes for the Hollywood because that will also give him a decent amount of culture with having four dramas and being able to build one multimedia the next turn. Elsie seats, so now I was really hoping that the impact of Harmony is revealed, but this is actually the impact of Balance, which is not really good news for me because that's the impact that I'm very bad in, and I will lose 8 culture to Elsie, which made my hope getting definitely less big, and Elsie sadly will fix this impact of Harmony now, will copy the classic army tactic going up to 27 strength, plays the revolutionary idea, goes for the democracy, is now at 10 culture reduction, also makes sure that the age will end, and then takes the satellites at the next turn, with being now at 7 civil action, could potentially, with having the engineering genius, even just take and finish the space flight, but maybe it could also be nice for him to just prepare for impacts, but could be a nice option for him. And sadly, that impact of Harmony or Balance reveal was quite a bit of a swing, because I had my turn can't see it, and during my turn I would have actually improved my balance, very likely with going for one more farm and upgrading one for free with the efficient upgrade, so I would have probably improved my balance by 4, while Elsie now improved his Harmony by 8, and also actually Elsie's pact with me will disappear now, and the one food production also resulted in 2 additional points from the impact of balance. So that was quite a bit of a swing. I will actually improve the impact of Harmony now, so at least I will be able to do this, but only by +4, and if it would already be out, I could use the population and resources elsewhere to maybe build a religion, which would score me 2 culture and maybe also help me for the impact. So yeah, that was sadly quite a swing, which impact is revealed. One way would be unlucky for Elsie, the other way is now a little bit unlucky for me. But now I have to hope that maybe Watson yet has seeded some impacts where I will also score very nicely, otherwise I think it's looking quite bad now. But at least the space flight, if Elsie just goes for it, it's not that big of a wonder for him, so I will get the bigger wonder. And if there are maybe just some nice impacts from Watson yet in there, there's maybe still a little bit of hope. Also, I will at least be able to get one additional culture production with offering the peace treaty to Watson Yates. I will use the ocean liner service. I will go for the democracy. I could build one movie with the urban growth and still have just enough resource left to finish the fast food chains, but the democracy also gives me 3 culture production, and then I can prepare myself for the impact of Harmony, build one farm, which also gives points for the fast food chains, upgrade it for free with the efficient upgrade, preparing myself also for potential impact of agriculture, build a warrior, and then play the reserves in order to be able to finish the fast food chains for 25 points, and with my last 2 actions I will actually take the military build-up and do nothing. Maybe I could have just taken one copy of reserves, because my thinking about not taking anything is that if Elsie doesn't want to just finish the space flight, he then can take and play the endowment, and if I don't take any cards, the chances are maybe bigger that it is still on 2 civil actions. But Watson yet at his turn can still take one card, and maybe it could be fine to take one copy of reserves, because if Watson yet now doesn't take any cards from the road, an endowment yes will stay on 2, but maybe Elsie could then also have the option to take a reserves, but then at least he doesn't get the endowment, so maybe it's just fine to not take any cards from the row. Watson yet seats, and impact of Harmony is revealed now. That is at least a somewhat nice one for me, but sadly, Elsie had not a chance to fix this a little bit, but it's still giving me +8 against both of them. And then Watson yet will go for multimedia, will be able to finish the Hollywood for 22 culture, and then builds one religion for a little bit of additional culture production. Now I was interested to see whether Elsie will go for the space flight or if he just does some other stuff. Watson has also took one copy of reserves away, meaning that Elsie doesn't have the option to go for one. He will see it, opens the arms industry, which sadly gives him 2 additional resources, but those won't make a difference for him during his turn. And then he won't go for the space flight, instead gets 6 cards from the endowment, gets more cards from building one team sports, builds even another one. Sadly, that makes the impact of competition that I've seeded even better for him, so that is now definitely not looking good for me. And before the final impacts, Elsie will, I think, have a little bit of a lead, as has 8 points before me, so that is definitely catchable, but sadly the only impact that I've seen it is actually giving him quite a lot of points now. Maybe it was the wrong decision to seed it, especially with the impact of Harmony not being revealed in time anyway. So I think that decision turned out to be quite bad now. Now I really need some good impacts from Watson Yates in order to have some hope to come back. And there is the impact of strength, maybe a reason why LC didn't want to go for the space flight. Building those team spots also made him the strongest, and with those plus 13 points, I think now there isn't really any hope left for me. Impact of architecture is revealed, which at least allows me to catch up a little bit. The impact of culture is revealed, which again, sadly, is not really a great impact for me. Then there is the impact of happiness, that one is at least somewhat fine for me, but again plus 2 points for LC. And at the end, the last impact is the impact of competition, giving LC plus 14 and for me only plus 7. So now at the end, it is even quite the distance for me to LC, and at the end, I clearly lose this game. And Watson Yates is able to win it, and his lead to LC isn't even that big, so LC at the end even had maybe some small chances to potentially win this game, but it's still a little bit of a gap, and I'm not sure if maybe there would have been another combination of impacts that would allow him to win. Maybe there would be. No, so this game didn't really go nicely for me at the end, but I also am really not sure if I navigated it very nicely. There were a lot of tough decisions during H3, also in H2, taking Napoleon for 3. Maybe it turned out to be a great decision. Maybe Watson Yates had a war in hand at this point, and it could have been a disaster to not take him. That was already a little bit questionable, maybe. And I then was able to get the ocean liner service, which was quite nice, but Watson Yates, I think, during H2 managed very nicely to make his position quite a bit explode. And then, I still thought at the beginning of H3 I have good chances for the second place, but sadly LC was able to get the team spots, and also then got Pierre, which definitely made it a bit harder to finish before him. And maybe I also just navigated it in the wrong way, maybe not going for the civil service, hoping to get a big military push could have been the right idea. At least I would have gotten the right cards for it at the end. If I wouldn't have been able to pull it off, I don't know, but I mean, LC I think would have had some difficulties to set up a big enough defense, so maybe that could have resulted in a better result, but I didn't know if I would get those cards, so I think it was still a reasonable decision to go for the civil service to make it that I'm not stuck on 5 civil actions. Then at the end, economically, I was not able to catch up to the others. I went for those 3 computers in order to develop some other technologies, but I think in order to display to pay off, I would have needed 1 or maybe 2 good impacts. I didn't have them, so maybe it was the wrong call to go for those. It was maybe a bit unfortunate to not get any more nice impacts, because I think there would have been definitely some variety, wonders, colonies, and of course science, progress, and so on. And with that, sadly, I lose the game, but as we saw at the end, there was also quite a difference, so 1 good impact definitely wouldn't have been enough. I think some swings would have to be a bit different. If maybe instead of the impact of competition, I would have a good impact, and maybe then 1 more good impact, and if the impact of harmony would be revealed earlier, maybe that could be enough. But that is already quite a lot that would have to go different. So at the end, I just navigated it in not the ideal way, and maybe the gambles that I took didn't really work out with seeding the impact of competition and with going heavily into those computers without having a really nicely payoff at the end. So at the end, sadly, I lose this game, which is definitely a bit of a setback against the 2 main contenders for the first place, and we can now see how the situation is looking at the standings. And there were at least 1 other game that has finished where I wasn't involved, so now we are going to take a look at the standings. And before the finish of this 3-player game, there were actually 3 2-player games finished between my opponents. As you can see here, that was the 2-player game against Watson Yates, a very close game, and there was an even closer game between ST and LC, where ST managed to finish with a 2 culture lead. And that outcome, of course, is quite could be quite important for me, because ST, LC not getting 4 points from that 2-player game. However, he did get 4 points from the 2-player game against Watsonians, which also was a very close one. So really a lot of close games during the stage. And then Watsonians also lost another 2-player game against ST. So those 3 games have finished in addition to the 3-player game that you just saw. And now we can take a look at what that means for the standings. And no, sadly for Watsonians, with losing those 2 2-player games against ST and LC, and also losing the one against me, even though he had now a very nice result in the game that you just saw, sadly it means that for him it won't be enough to move on to the next stage. He is now at 7 games finished in 11 points, has only 1 game left, so he is sadly out. And also ST, with LC scoring some more points, has now no chances any longer, even though he won now 2 2-player games, is now at 9 points. But even if he wins the last 2 games, he won't have enough to move on to the next stage. So now in the final games, it will be decided between LC and me. LC has quite a lead at the moment in the standing, 7 points before me, but he also has 2 more games finished already. So that is definitely the advantage that I am having. And the next game that you will see on this channel is then actually a 2-player game between me and LC. And if I should lose this game, I am out of the tournament, because then even if I should win the last 2 games, I can only score 9 points, but LC would have 26, I would have 24. So I really need to win this next 2-player game, and then also score even some more results in order to have more than 20 points at the end. So the next game should be very exciting, and might be then deciding whether I will be able to move on to the finals or not. So I hope you're excited for that. And then thanks for watching, have a nice time, and see you in the next video.